Hi, welcome. I'm James. We're going to do a 20-minute yoga session here. It's the first of a four-part series. Remember, always check with your doctor first before starting any exercise. Just do what you can. If it doesn't feel right, don't do it. Please modify. All right, so what the first one is going to be, we're going to do a little bit of a warrior sequence. So, starting in front of the mat, inhale, sweeping up the arms. Exhale, fold, hinging forward. Inhale, sweeping up the arms. Exhale, pulling the palms. One more, inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale. Palms in. A little sun salutation here. Inhaling up. Exhale, fold. Flat back, extend the spine. Exhale, step on back, bottom of a push-up. Toes point back. We're gonna roll ourselves up. Shoulders back, navel pulls in, protecting the lower back. Passing through the knees, curl toes, lift. Find a nice little downward dog, fingers spread wide. Kind of walk your dog for a second. Just one heel, then the other. Both heels back, lift the hips, sink. Inhale, bend the knees. Exhale, walk your way forward. Flat back. Fold. Inhale, sweeping it up. One more, here we go. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Flat back. Step on back and go at your own pace. Bottom of push-up. Toes point back, up dog, rounding up. Careful on the lower back. Slide to the knees, lift. We're taking a slightly more cautious way. You feel free to take however you want to get into these poses. One more breath. Bend the knees. Walk it through. Flat back. Fold. Sweep it up. Stepping our right leg back first. Find a nice warrior heel, points to instep, arms up, opening out. Relax the shoulders, check the hands, make sure everything's in a nice straight line. Sinking down. Back toes can point slightly forward, out to the side. If it's uncomfortable in the ankle, you can point the toes away. You want to keep the front knee either behind the ankle or over, not past. Drop the tailbone. Breathing deep, relax. Close the eyes, gazing straight ahead if you can. We're going to take rest of the forearm on the thigh. We're going to extend the other arm up. Opening the chest, drop the tailbone a little bit if you can. Maybe you can take the lower hand to the floor. Maybe not today. Maybe you're doing it on the inside, that's okay. Wherever you are at. And just breathe into the hips, waist, and lower back. Gently pulling in the hand, straighten the front leg. Maybe you can take the legs wide, or maybe you need to shorten a little bit for triangle. We're gonna bring up the arms, shift the hip, reach forward, and then just lower down. Maybe you're grabbing the shin. Maybe the palms on the floor, wherever you're at. Open the chest and breathe. Your gaze can be down at the floor, straight out. It's up across the palm, only if that's comfortable. We're gonna lengthen that front leg back. So that left leg is lengthening, right hip lifting a little bit. And bring it up. Pivoting on the heels. Gonna go into the warrior on the other side now. Opening the hips out. Tummy in, tailbone drops, arms up. Now depending on what's comfortable with your shoulders, I prefer to bring up the arms, drop the shoulders, and then open them out. Relax. Gazing down the front fingertips, eyes closed if you can. If you're not there yet, don't worry about it. And breathe. Forearm down. Side angle stretch, reaching through, open the chest. Drop the tailbone. Again, if you can, palm to the floor. If not, that's okay. You can also do this with the back knee on the floor, reaching through. It's all about where you're at today. Just breathe, relax. Find what has to work and what doesn't. Bring it up. So we're going to shorten that stance again for most people. Heel to instep, arms up, shift, reach, and then lower down. Extend the spine. Again, right leg lengthening back, left hip lifting. Taking it where you are comfortable. For most people, are going to be gazing at the floor, maybe straight out, only up across the palm if it's comfortable with the neck. Soften now. Gently bring it up, pivoting the toes straight ahead. We're going to take a little shorter, kind of a medium stance here. Hands on the hips, hinge down. Keep your toes pointed forward. We're going to try to interlace the fingers behind the back. Maybe they're resting on the back. Maybe you're not ready for that and you need palms on the floor. If you can lift the arms and hinge, do so. Just take the arms up as high as they can go. And just relax. Just kind of hang there. Find again what has to work and what doesn't have to work. And release slowly, palms to the floor. Straighten the spine. Again, check. Find a comfortable place. We're going to place the left hand right below the nose. Right arm sweeps up, extend the back. Maybe your arm only goes this high, that's okay. If you can take it all the way up, take it up. Careful you're not winging the shoulder. Lower down, adjust. Left arm sweeps up, lengthen the spine. Again, gaze can be down, out, or up. Placing palms down. We're going to walk the feet out a comfortable distance. pushing back into the hips. Maybe. Now, if you have a bolster or block, you can feel free to rest your arm on those. Maybe you can come to the forearms. If you're up on the palms going, no, that's not going to happen, that's okay. Maybe you can walk the hands back and set the forehead or reach the palms behind you and gently pull it. My preference right here. Relax the hips. We do not want to feel too much going on in the inside of the knee. So if you are, please come out of a little. We want to feel it in here, that's fine, but not on the inside of the knee. We don't want the knees buckling in. Breathe. A couple more breaths. Good, we're gonna walk our way up, walking in the feet. At about halfway, hands to the hips, round up slowly, take your time. Lift the chest, give it a back bend, and come on back. So we're gonna take our hands down, we're gonna step back. Keep your knees right to the short side of the mat. We're gonna do what's called gate. We're gonna extend the left leg out to the side, bring ourselves up, knee right below the hip. We're gonna inhale, sweeping up the outside arm, right arm. Exhale, stretching to the left. Maybe your hand is on the thigh or shin. If you can turn the palm up, you can. Breathe into the ribs. If the extended foot's not comfortable flat down, you can turn it forward. Remember, we want to feel good stretch. We want to feel challenge. But listen to your body. If it's telling you something isn't right, don't do it. Inhale. Lower down. Stepping in. We're going to step the right leg out to the side now, bring it up, keeping the hip right above the knee. Inhale, sweeping up the arm. Exhale, stretching across. So left arm coming to the right. Chest opens a little. Try to keep all this hip over the knee. But most of the weight, once you start to stretch, most of the weight should be over in that right leg. Eyes soft, let the head just kind of find a comfortable position. Breathe. We're gonna bring the knees in together. If sitting back into hero pose is not comfortable, you can stay here. If sitting back into hero is comfortable, kind of tuck the heels to the outside. Find a comfortable place. Let the thighs stretch a little bit for a moment. Taking a couple deep breaths here. We're gonna bring up the right arm, reach back. Grab the elbow, and if you need to take a comfortable seated pose, you can also take a seated pose. Maybe reach up, grab the elbow. If you can reach the arm comfortably behind the back and take the bind with the fingers, you may do that as well. So wherever you're at, relax the shoulders down. Keep the eyes and face off. Make sure you're not pulling the arm into the head. Release. Roll. Bring yourself up for a moment. Go ahead and curl the toes under. Give it a little back bend for a second. and back. Lowering down one more time. Now, if you're in seated, stay in seated. So we're going to bring up the left arm, reaching back, grabbing the elbow. Again, if you can grab the fingers behind the back, do so. Relax the shoulders down. Eyes and face soft. If you are in hero pose, relax the thighs, let them soften. Maybe turn off the butt cheeks. And release. Roll down. So let's all go ahead and we'll take ourselves now to the floor. If you're already seated there, maybe switch your sides. So we're going to take just a comfortable seated, rolling out the shoulders, bringing the right arm across the chest, hooking the left arm underneath, sitting up tall. Relax the right shoulder. Now if you want to take the modification, bringing palm to palm, you can. It's always been one of my nemesis there. Growing tall. Relax the shoulders. Release. Roll. So left arm across. Hooking the elbow under. Again, if you want to just go into the bind, you can go into the bind. Again, yours probably looks a lot better than mine. It's never been a good pose for me. Working on it though. 20 years, I'm determined I will get that pose one day. Grow tall, relax the shoulders. Release. Roll. So check the sit bones for a moment. Make sure it's comfortable. Chest bone is lifted, shoulders down. We're going to take the right palm, a little carpal tunnel stretch here. So be careful with it. Don't put a lot of strength or pressure in these. Right palm's going to face up. Left fingers come right over the fingers of the other hand. We're going to drop the left palm. Lift the right. The cheat way is, remember, the palm facing up goes up, palm facing down goes down. Again, keep the shoulders down. Sometimes they do this. Keep them down. These aren't long stretches and not intense. Shake it out. Left palm up, right palm over the top, dropping the right elbow, right wrist, left wrist comes up. Shoulders relax, breathing. Release, shake it out. We're gonna take the palms out in front of us, kind of check the sit bones. Maybe this is as far as you can go. Maybe you can take yourself and extend yourself out. Take a deep breath. Exhale, sink. You can either press and round or extend. Never compress the spine if you can help it. Always lengthening. Breathe soft and gentle. Deep breaths into the back, the rib cage, the abdomen. Walk your way back. Placing the palms behind you, we're just going to lift the chest for a second. If you can roll up the lower back, the hips, do so. If you're not there, don't worry about it. And down. Adjust. So we're going to bring up the right arm. We're going to place the left hand across the knee. We're going to place the right palm to the base of the spine. Get as close in there as you can. We're going to pull gently on an exhale with the left hand looking around behind us. Don't force the neck, just let the head go along for the ride. Eyes are closed. Taking a few deep breaths there. If you have trouble getting the palm behind you, you could put a bolster, a block, pillow behind it and rest the palm on it. Gently come back. Right hand across, left arm up. Exhale, lower the palm. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, twist. Breathing. Soften the shoulders, relax the face. And bring it back. So we're going to extend the legs forward, rolling them out for a moment. We're going to lower back, stretch it out, fingertips, toes, big stretch. Placing palms alongside of you, walking back the heels. We're going to press with the thighs, rounding up the best you can. Keep the ankles below the knees. If you need to keep palms on the floor, that's okay. If you can interlace the fingers and tuck the shoulders, keep the chin in comfortably. We don't want to be putting pressure into the neck. The shoulders should be doing the work. Shoulder blades, the scapula. And lower down. Flatten the back, extend. We'll slowly bring in the knees, give it a little hug, rolling it out. Happy baby pose. We're going to reach in, we're going to grab the feet, we're going to open the knees, and just let the arms hang down. Taking a few breaths, if you want to roll a little bit here, you can, or if you just want to pull it in, if you want to work to open the feet out a little, maybe your big toe can touch the floor, that's great. Relax, soften, and breathe. Slowly, we're going to extend the legs out. Find a comfortable place on the mat. We're going to take the feet out about the width of the mat, allowing the pinky to turn out to the side. Tuck the shoulder blades under. Maybe rest the palms face out about 45 degrees to the side. Again, you can tuck the shoulder blades. Find a comfortable place. Maybe lift the butt cheeks and kind of bring them together. We're just going to take a few breaths here today and just relax. Even warriors need to rest. So soften the cheeks, the lips, and the tongue. Relaxing the brow, the forehead, and the scalp. Allowing the ears to melt back towards the floor. Now release the tension in the base of the nose, the bridge of the nose. deep, steady breath. Just clearing the mind for just a few more breaths. Just let all of your thoughts go. Just be an observer. Everything. Warrior has to be mindful of all of his surroundings. You can't afford to get hung up on just focusing on small things. Too many small things, and we can't see everything else going on. So let your breaths deepen again, wiggling fingertips and toes. Inhale, stretching out the arms. Carefully walk your way back. If you need to go into fetal position on the side, that's okay. And when you're ready, you can lie there as long as you like and just rest. When you're ready, come to seated resting. Palms on the knees, chest lifted, chin down, eyes closed. Thank you for sharing this little warrior practice with me. Peace. Namaste.